shades.
Did you have to get the 25 to wear the shades in post game?
I just always wanted to walk into a post game interview feeling like Russell Westbrook. So this is my me time with my fashion. Shout out to Russ.
Mitch, what were the emotions of today like for you?
You know, I was trying not to think about it before the game, you know, just because if you think about things too much, things can get forced. So I just tried to play as loose as I could, you know, and it showed on the court. You know, I played well offensively and defensively and was able to help my team today.
Mitch, walk us through the pump fake, the dunk, the screen.
Well, I got the shot first, and my coach kind of told me during a timeout that I got him on the rope, so a pump fake would get him up in the air, and I'd be able to go to the basket. And sure enough, the next time I got it at the high post, I pump faked and was able to get it to the basket. So shout out Coach Coop.
Mitch, what did it mean to you just to have everyone doing that MVP chant when you were on the court today for senior day?
You know, it's really special to be respected like that. You know, at a school that values the things that they value, you know, to be appreciated like I was today is really special.
Another big game against Kansas for you, but you know, to sweep them, what's that mean? Even 17 years to do that.
I mean, it's great to be a part of the history that this school has. You know, I'm fortunate enough to be able to write my name in the record books. You know, when we look back, you know, and everyone's talking about the tradition we have, I'll be part of it now, and that's really special.
Mitch, bring me through your experience of the Storm Court, where you went, and just the euphoria of that on senior day.
It's such a special experience. You know, I think every player should get to experience something like that. I've been fortunate to experience a couple, and to see your hard work pay off over the course of the game, and to see the fans appreciate you and celebrate you like that, it's really special.
I mean, it was great. I think this is the third time this season we've had a Storm Court, and that's the first time in my career that, you know, I was able to experience that. But, I mean, the fans tonight were awesome. So, you know, I'm just happy we got to share that moment with them.
Kendall, when Kansas got within 9 points there, you hit a fadeaway three from the corner. How big of a shot was that? What did you see on that play?
I just saw an opening. You know, we run a lot of two-man game. Kuba came off, gave me the ball clean, and I thought I had a good look at it, so I just shot it.
Kendall, I know that this is the first game at home that your mom had gotten to see you play today. What did that mean to you just to have all your family here?
Yeah, I mean, great. Was able to get 19 people from California to come to the game tonight. So, I mean, my support staff is phenomenal. Unfortunately, my mom and dad had to get back to get to church tomorrow. But I'll talk to them another time. But it was special to have them here.
Kendall, you get to walk in here feeling like Russell Westbrook. It seemed like you were hitting a lot of your shots out there. Were you having fun?
Definitely. I think, you know, one thing Jeff Carroll always talks about before we take the floor is, you know, make sure we have fun. He always preaches that. And just for Mitch and for Sean and for Jeff to go out, I thought when we beat Iowa State, you know, that was good for them to, you know, set their name in the record book for that. But tonight to you know, beat a really good team at home and on the road, first team to do that in, what you said, 17 years. It was just more special for them, and I was happy I was able to share that with them.
Mitch, when you think back on your journey, kind of your family and them being here today, being from Bixby, I mean, you know, what has it been like, you know, growing up here and rising through the basketball ranks?
It's so special to have myself progress like I have. You know, I came in and kind of just came off the bench, was a role player, and every year I've gotten better and better. You know, all the coaches that I've had have helped me to progress skill-wise and mentally. And to be able to end it like this is indescribable. You know, I put a cap on the dream that I've lived for 4 years.
What would it mean to you guys to be able to play in March Madness, and why do you think you deserve to be there for both of you guys?
I mean, it'd mean the world to me to be able to go out like that through all we've been through. You know, we've stuck together through it all, and we've beaten really good teams, and we've shown that we can compete against anyone in the country. So, I mean, going out like that would be so special.
Devontae Graham and Bill Self each said that they thought you all are definitely an NCAA tournament caliber team. How are you all feeling about your tournament chances right now?
I mean, I just think, you know, whoever's making the decisions, just, I mean, look at, you know, what we've done over the course of the season. We went on the road and we got wins. You know, we won the games at home when they counted. So, I don't think if they put us in the tournament, you know, it'd be a bad thing. I think it'd be a plus.
What do you think it is about this team that makes you able to exceed in emotionally charged environments like there was tonight?
I mean, I think our chemistry has a lot to do with that. You know, this is one of the closest teams I've ever been on. There's no groups. We're all just one giant group. And when things get tough off the court and on the court during games, we're able to lean on each other and count on one another to pick us up, pick each other up, and finish whatever we've started.
Kendall, you're the two highest scoring teams of the year. Something about the matchup or the stage of playing Kansas that helps you lock in even more?
I think my teammates just did a really good job of putting me in positions to score. The confidence that they have in me just helps me, you know, build the confidence in myself. So, I mean, I owe it all to them, really.
Great players show up against great competition.
How have you guys been able to continue not get down? You guys have had rough stretches, and yet here you said, with a very legitimate chance to say you're an NCAA tournament team. Why are you guys in this position?
I think, you know, Mitch talked about our chemistry, but I think with this group, you know, there's not a guy that feels like, oh, I have to get this or he has to get this shot. Like, we genuinely want to see each other be successful. So, you know, if we lose a game, that next day in practice, he's pushing me harder than I've been pushed before, you know. And I think, you know, when he holds us to that standard, and obviously Coach Mike holds us to a really high standard, but when you got different players that can hold each other to those standards, you can bounce back from anything.
You guys were picked to finish last in the Big 12 going into this year. Did you guys focus on blocking out the noise going in, or was it embracing the culture that underdog mentality?
We didn't care about what they preseason rankings were. I think Coach mentioned it. The first practice we had, he pulled out the paper and said, look, this is where they have us. He's like, I'm not going to say it again. I'm not going to talk about it again. But we know what we need to do. So I think that was the right approach to take.
Is this the most complete game that you can recall in your career?
Probably. Tonight, my shots were falling, and I was making plays. I was making plays on defense too. Some of the games that I've had in my career where I played well offensively, I've kind of slacked on defense, but that wasn't the case tonight. I felt like I played a complete game, whether it was my help defense, you know, it was my on-ball defense, my post defense, my scoring ability. I think it all came together tonight.
First time you guys have won back-to-back Big 12 games this year. Does that say something about gaining consistency?
Absolutely. I think we've kind of turned a corner. You know, we've realized that our backs are against the wall, and we're ready to fight back.
Yeah, definitely. Like you said, we know that we weren't in the best, you know, position tournament-wise. Before, I believe, the Texas Tech game, you know, Coach said, you know, we got a four-game season left. He didn't talk about the past. He just talked about our next four games. So I think when we took that approach, it really helped us, kind of gave us a fresh jump start. So, you know, we finished the four-game season off 3-1. And I'm pretty sure tomorrow in film, you know, he'll have another whatever say, you know, he does, but he'll prepare us for a tournament.
Coach goes out there post-game, gives a speech to the crowd. You know, this program's just getting started. You guys are going to hang a banner. Obviously, you guys are seniors and won't be part of that, but what does that message mean to you?
It's really special, at least for me. I know Kendall probably feels the same, but being an Oklahoma kid, you know, to be able to lay the foundation for this program to hopefully see those highs is going to be so special to look back on when I bring my kids back, you know, and grandkids and all that. It's going to be really special.
You guys think you're in the tournament now, but I suppose you play Oklahoma Wednesday night, winner goes on, the NCAA, the loser has to sell for the NIT, which would be all right with that.
We're playing our hearts out no matter what, so it doesn't matter to us.
Facts.
Who was kind of the most emotional of you seniors today?
I think Jeff cried.
Yeah, probably mind. Jeff.
Anything else, guys? I'll get coach for you. Thanks.
Thank you.
I hadn't had a chance to do this, but I do want to congratulate Coach Self and his team, his program on what's, I'm not sure it's as appreciated as it should be. I mean, I won't be alive if it ever happens again, that's for sure. 14 in a row in this league with this competition. So congrats to him for winning the league and going in with the number one seed. I think they probably should be the number one overall seed in the tournament. But I'm really proud of our guys, particularly our seniors. We talked all week about finishing, and people always remember how you finish. And I think they took that to heart and played in a way that will be remembered for a really, really long time. And so I'm really thankful to them for allowing me and my staff to coach them the way we felt like we needed to coach them to have success this year. Obviously, everybody who's been here knows it's not been a smooth ride. It's been a lot of ups and downs, but these kids have been really resilient, and I couldn't be more proud to see them grow the way they have over the course of the season. With that, I'll take any questions. Yeah.
I was just going to say, not just finishing, starting. You got to think this was the best game all season long, start to finish.
Yeah, I mean, I haven't thought about it that way, but we were locked in. Our guys played with a determination today that we haven't had consistently throughout the year. I'll say that. I'm really proud of them. I mean, proud really doesn't really do it justice for how I feel about this group. For them giving me the opportunity when I was named the head coach, there were a lot of people who said, "Who? What are they doing in Stillwater? And why would they decide to not care about basketball anymore?" And as rich as this program is, for those guys to block out that noise, for the parents of these kids to continue to have them believe in us means a lot. So I'm thankful to all of them for, they're the reason we're here. It's those kids because of the work they've done.
You mentioned the ups and downs. This isn't the first time you've done it after a game. For you to circle the court and give those hugs out and to see your players celebrate, I mean, like, what's the emotions for you?
This is their program. I mean, I've said that for a long time. I just happen to be the guy who has the title of head coach. And I meant that when I said it in my press conference. I've got two guys on my staff who could run this program. They're very capable head coaches. They've been a big part of the success we've had this year. But this program belongs to our fans and our former players, the alumni here who all have degrees hanging on their walls wherever they work. That's what it's about. And they need to know that they're appreciated. And when they're here, I want to make sure that I give them that opportunity.
Mentioned after the game, the four-game season that you had talked about a couple weeks ago.
Sure.
You guys, 3-1 and the one loss comes basically at the buzzer. What have you seen in these last 2 weeks out of this team that has allowed them to, I guess, be more consistent maybe than previously?
Yeah, I mean, I think it's been a consistent focus. We struggled with that, I don't know, maybe 4-6 weeks, give or take. I have to go back and look exactly. But we would play really well for half and not play well for big chunk of a game, and it would cost us. We can't overcome those type of things. But we play with a consistent focus for four games that's put ourselves in position to have success. And, the loss at Texas, I was really concerned about my team on Sunday last week. It's a really hard thing to overcome. We outplayed Texas, I felt like, and I think our team felt like we did. But the result is sometimes what you don't, it's hard. It's hard to feel that way when it's a loss. And again, at that point, the season's over. This is, team's done, and for the probably 8th or 9th time. But for those guys to come back, because we had to practice Sunday because we played Tuesday, and they practice with incredible energy, and they were refocused immediately, knowing that we still had a chance to finish those four games in a good way, not as good. The leadership and just the toughness, the resilience of those kids is unbelievable.
Mike, do you feel like you're an NCAA tournament winner, or is there still work to be done in your mind?
I mean, I've always felt like we were an NCAA tournament team. whether we're going to get in or not, but, you know, though we don't make that decision. I know if we continue to win, we kind of take that out of the question. So we just have to go prepare for a game on Wednesday and then take care of the things that we do control, which is how we play. And then, you know, we'll see. But I think that this team is capable of getting in the tournament and having success.
It seems like this is a team, too, that if the, I know the committee won't be looking at this, but you've been as competitive here late as probably anybody in the country, knocking off top teams. It seems like if they want competitive games, your guys will deliver.
Yeah, I don't know how the thought process works. You know, we're still talking about humans, and everybody's got a different way to think about things. But I think if you watch us play, and certainly if you've watched us play here in the last 2 weeks, you look out there and say, wow, that team is really good. And we don't wow you with a bunch of pros, but collectively, got a pretty good group. And, you know, they showed that today against a team that will likely be a number one seed. And I don't know if they're going to be number one overall, but they'll be in that top line.
I'm asking Kenny's question over again, but I'm looking for a different answer. You look at teams this time of the year, there's a lot of tired basketball teams. I mean, even good teams that are tired. Your team seems to look better than they did when they marched out for game one. That effort today, what do you – I know there's resiliency, but what do you equate to the energy level that they're playing with right now?
That's just determination. My guys aren't as fresh as they were in November. There's no doubt about that. I think mentally they feel just as good, though. You know, by design, we don't try to play guys 30 in the 30s. We try not to over the course of the season. That wears on guys. And as hard as we try to demand them to play, it's hard to have that type of success if you're going to play guys 35 minutes a game. And we've gotten contributions from a lot of different places throughout the course of the season. So, you know, I would just attribute it to the kids' mentality. Like, they're not going to allow that to be an excuse for them. Everybody's tired. Everybody's sore. Everybody's dealing with some aches and pains here and there. And so, you know, they've just said, that's not going to mean more than what I want to achieve. I'm going to do it anyway. I'm going to do it even though it hurts a little bit. I'm going to commit to my team because they need me to do X, Y, Z, depending on the day.
At the end of the game, Jeffrey Carroll got a little emotional. Both the guys in here before you said he was the most emotional of all the seniors. For how calm and cool and collected he always seems, did that surprise you at all to see that emotion from him?
Not really. He's really an emotional kid. He doesn't know how to show it. Sometimes he shows it through frustration. This has been an unbelievable year for him. And people look at it and say he didn't have as good a season as he was expected to or as he did last year. He was asked to lead this team. He's never been asked to lead a team before in his life. In fact, he's never been asked to lead anything in his life. And he's always been a guy who's been able to kind of, not skate by, but blend in and be a third or fourth option. And he accepted that. He took a lot of it on. And his head coach didn't even start him for the first five games that he was eligible to play for us. He never complained once. To me, that goes a lot further than how many points he averaged, whether it was 3 points down from last year or not. So I can see he's been through a lot in his career. You know, played for three head coaches, watched a teammate die. All those things matter. And when you think about it, that'll make you emotional a little bit.
Just going back to making March, on paper, do you feel like you have the resume to get in, or do you think you have to do more next week?
I don't know. I don't think about that. I know on Wednesday we have a game. That's what I know. And between now and Wednesday, my job is to get my team ready to play. If we're ready to play, we play well, the resume stuff takes care of itself. If we're not ready to play and don't play well, the opposite happens.
Lawrence, you out-rebounded. You did in the first half today, but not the second for the game. They ended up on top. But the turnovers, those seem to be the most dramatic attribute for your team in winning the game. Would you agree?
Yeah, I think we were really aggressive on both ends of the court. That was one of the keys. You're not going to beat a team that talented, that well coached, for a second time by hoping the clock runs out when you have a lead. it's not going to happen by hoping they miss shots. Or you have to go win. You have to go make plays. You have to make up your in your mind. You're not going to allow them to come back when you get a 13-point lead or 14-point lead. It's one of the things that hurt us last week. We got up double figures, and all of a sudden the lead was gone in like 2 minutes. We didn't take advantage of the opportunity to hold them off or extend the lead like we did today.
Back at your first season as a head coach, this class of seniors, the ups and downs you went through, and to have a win like this, what are you going to remember about these four guys?
I don't know, to be honest, Nikki. I really haven't thought about it. To me, it's not about me. At some point, I'll think about what our staff and team was able to accomplish. Right now, I just want to ride as much as I can off these seniors and give them the best opportunity to have the most success they can have. I don't know what that is. And obviously the tournament's a lot about matchups and all that stuff. And there's no guarantee we get there. So I reflect, but I'm really proud of being the coach at Oklahoma State. And I'm happy that Kendall Smith decided to take a chance on me.
What did that mean to you just to have all the fans recognize him?
I don't know. I've seen that since June. You know, he's made these plays every day. He does it in practice, even when I tell him not to do it in practice. I try not to practice. I don't need him to get hurt in practice. And those plays sometimes lead to injuries. Those extra effort, you putting yourself in a collision position or whatever. But he deserved to play the way he did today. He earned that. I wasn't sure who that was out there when he shot fake and went down the lane and dunked. In fact, I turned to the radio guys during the game and I asked them who was wearing number 41 for us today. But it's true. In life, you get what you work for. He earned today's performance.
Kendall Smith coming into the postgame presser saying he'd always wanted to feel like Russell Westbrook wearing his sunglasses and everything. What's it like just to have his, not just his basketball skill, but his personality on the team this season?
Yeah, Kendall's an interesting study. man. Yeah, I did this drill. I'll tell you guys this. There's a video of it somewhere. I'm sure somebody posted it somewhere. I did this drill yesterday for my seniors where I gave them an opportunity to put me on defense. And on a part of the play, I was going to take a charge. And then I had to dive on the floor for a loose ball. Well, Kendall was the guy who wound up with the ball for me to take the charge on. And I just thought through my head, because I knew I was going to do this. I was concerned if I was going to get injured. And I know that some of my players would have taken that opportunity to try to barrel their shoulder or elbow right into my chest, because I asked for it. I couldn't complain. And before I could get to the position to take a charge, he was in the air trying to dunk on me. And then he sent me a picture of it later that day. But that's Kendall. He does a lot of good things to help us win. He drives me crazy sometimes. But I love him all the same because he's extremely competitive. He wants to learn. He wants to be good. He wants to lead. And it's my job to help him do that. But I'm really thankful that he decided to come here and help us have the success we've had this year.
Coach, obviously every win is so important, so big in this league, but specifically beating Kansas, beating them twice, no one's done that since 2001. What's it mean to beat this Kansas team, not once but twice?
It means I got some tough guys. Because, again, I think if you lined us up again and said you guys play again, we'd be underdogs. And you can do it 10 more times and 20 more times. And we still, I mean, the margin, maybe it would get a little bit smaller. I don't know what it is. I got tough kids. I got kids who are really competitive. I got kids who care about Oklahoma State basketball. And you know, one of the challenges, I talked about this in the media, was you can't try to beat them by yourself. It's easy to say, this is my opportunity on senior day. I'm going to go try to score 30. And nobody did that. You know, they played within themselves. We had a segment there. We didn't guard a rebound as well. And those things happen. But I'm just a really proud coach today to have the opportunity to coach them.
We talked about the four-game season that Kendall said you kind of talked about the last couple of weeks. Now you move ahead to a new challenge. What is the message and what is going to be key against Oklahoma?
I mean, I haven't thought about it a ton. Maybe next time we get a chance to visit, I'll have thought through that. Tournament time special. It's a special time of year. You know, playing meaningful games in March, it's a big deal. There are a lot of people who are, the season is either over or the guys on the team can't wait until it's over. Been there. I call those guys spring breakers. Been there, all right? And it's hard to grind it out when your season isn't going as well as you wanted it to go. And not everybody on our team's had the type of season individually that they wanted to, but they've continued to buy into what we wanted to do as a team, and it's the reason we've been able to have some of the success we've had.
Mike, you said a little while ago you weren't sure what the committee was going to be thinking. I don't know if anyone knows. I think it's safe to assume they're not going to buy 9 to get from the conference. The NCAA, that would be a story. Maybe it will. Maybe that'll happen. But it's doubtful. If I was to say that your game with Oklahoma becomes a de facto play-in game, winner goes on, loser settles for the NIT, would you be comfortable with that?
Yeah, I mean, I'll take this team anywhere against anybody. I think we can beat anybody. I believe that. I mean, that's not just me sticking up for my guys. I believe if we're in the right frame of mind and if we play with the type of focus that we're capable of, I don't care where the game is, who it's against, who the other coach is, who the other team has on their roster. I believe in these guys that much. Whether or not it's a playing game, I don't know. I won't approach it that way. I think 9 teams in this league can get in. I said 10 teams about 2 months ago. I don't think 10 will get in. I think there are 9 teams in this league that deserve an opportunity to show they can have success in the tournament.
You've been a part of senior nights before, but how different are the emotions for you when you're the guy at the end of the tunnel that they're all walking towards?
It's different because, like for Mitchell Solomon, knowing that I'm coming up on the last few games to coach that kid and what he's about, this makes it hard. He is what college basketball is about, that kid right there. All the stories that everybody talks about every day, it's insane that we can't find a way to give young people hope. Be a good student, treat people right, work hard, and it's not about money. It's not about investing. It's about Mitchell Solomons. This is supposed to be about the Mitchell Solomons of the world. But no one wants to tell that story because I don't know. We don't live in that type of society, I guess, that wants to celebrate those type of things. But there's a kid somewhere in Oklahoma that if he heard Mitchell Solomon's story, may be inspired. Maybe. And I think we're missing an opportunity because we refuse, for whatever reason, to celebrate those things because I don't know if it doesn't sell or whatever, there's pressure. I don't understand it. But for the life of me, I think we'd be much better off if we told those stories more and we allow people to understand that it's not about getting as much as you can. It's about what you put into things. And then today happens. Today happens for Mitchell Solomon. Because he deserved it.
How important has he been, I guess? Is it interesting to you that he's been the leader on your team in a season like this? You talk about all the ups and downs he's been there.
I don't know. I don't know if it's, you assume your seniors will be your leaders. I mean, he's not the most vocal person, but it's hard to argue when you watch that kid work every day that when he tells you to do something, it's hard to not do it. It's easier to ignore the guy who says to stay after when he's the first guy to leave the gym after practice. That's not him. On a team of guys who are kind of thrown together, not necessarily thrown together, who were together but had a coach thrown on them late, for him to be the leader is kind of a big deal. But he's the guy. Without our team is a bunch of guys who no one thinks any good. And he may be the least in terms of natural ability of the scholarship players that we have. He may have the least natural ability from a basketball standpoint. And he's the most important guy in that locker room every single day.
Bill Self thinks you're pretty good. He said you're a much better team than he has. You have a much better team than he has.
I'm not going to argue with him. I don't. He's won the league 14 years in a row, so I guess. maybe at some point I get to that level of success, I'll feel that comfortable saying those things.
Anything else, guys? We'll have an availability before we leave on Monday, probably 11.